I'm a huge fan of using Google Docs to create my genealogy research reports and writing projects. If you want to make your genealogy research reports look awesome blossom, then be sure to use these five skills to make it look fantastic. Now, there are a lot of tools that you can use on Google Docs to enhance the look of your research reports and your research projects, but I'm going to share with you five. Be sure to check out the FHF Extra channel membership for a more in-depth video series that I will have just for members only on how some other tips and tricks on improving the styling and the look of your reports. My first technique is to stylize headings. Not only do you want to have them different sizes, but you also want to be able to have them have different fonts and colors. So here I have a basic research report. I've got something where it's going to be a title, the objective, the background, and the other elements that you would expect to see in a research report. And notice it's not really stylized and it's rather boring. To stylize your headings, we're going to go ahead and highlight a title, and then we're going to go to this normal text. I don't want normal text. I want it to say title. Now, title is just a default. You know, it's rather kind of boring, but I'm going to go ahead and adjust my title, center it, and then I can change the font. One of my favorites is Brie Serif. And then if I want to, I can change the color. And as you know, I'm a huge fan of maroon. That one's the wrong kind of maroon, and I can go like that. Lots of other styling techniques that I can use right there. So what about these subheadings? So let's do subtitle one and subtitle two and subtitle three. Pretty easy, right? However, let's say you're working on any of these and you decide, you know, that's still kind of boring. I would like to make it Oswald and I want to reduce the font. Another thing you might want to do is maybe you have too much line spacing around that heading, to go to line and paragraph spacing, and you can click single, and that just reduces a little bit of the spacing down there. Make that a capital I. And let's say you want to give it a color as well. So we're going to colorize. Oops, not underline. Well, you could underline. Maybe you want it purple. I don't know. Let's go ahead and put the underline there as well. Why not? Well, if you go like this and do a paint, that works. If you make changes to the heading style that you've already articulated, then you have to go back and repaint every single one. But there's an easier way. What I can do to make my life easier, and watch this, I'm going to have both of them at the same time. I'm going to highlight this. I'm going to go to heading, click on this heading, and then I'm going to come down here to update heading to match. And then not only was that one fixed, so is that one fixed. And any time I add heading one, now it looks like that. So let's say I want to make this heading one, and then I change this, like, I don't really like the purple. I'd much rather have a green. The other ones haven't changed, so I have to go back to heading, update heading to match, and now they're all green. Now, you shouldn't have to do anything extra in order to do update heading to match. It should have already been built into your program. If you don't have that in Google Docs, then do a Google search for how do I do update heading to match, and then there's somebody, you will have a tool that you can have. But for me, I found that it is just built into this program. I just never knew what it was for. Now, who likes to see just a huge body of text with no formatting? Well, maybe if it is from a genealogy book from the distant past, then sure. But today we have a way to enhance the look of our reports by stylizing our content. So one of the first things that you might want to do with formatting your content is definitely doing the same thing we did for the paragraph, the titles, but also formatting your paragraphs. You can do format, line spacing. Maybe you want 1.5 between each line, or maybe you want it single spaced. Lots of options there. Another thing you can do is add space before a paragraph. And then if you had one or more paragraphs, you're going to see that you have extra spacing between your paragraphs. Another thing you could do to format your paragraphs is actually format your titles and your paragraphs in one fell swoop. So highlight all of the sections that you want, click on Format, Line and Paragraph Spacings, and do Keep with Next. So what happens if you do a big section like that, all of it drops down and you have this big space. If I didn't have that Keep with Next and it add paragraphs, notice that the title and the first paragraph under that title splits. So if you want to keep the title and a first paragraph together, then highlight, line spacing, keep with next. Another thing you might want to do is create lists. And lists are fairly easy to create. Let's say you want this right here to be a bulleted list. Depending on how zoomed in you are, so if we could zoom out, 1, 2, you're going to see those three dots and you can click on the bulleted list. I'm going to zoom back in, but you click on the bulleted list and now I have a bullet. And anytime I add another line, it'll be a bullet every time I hit enter. If you want to make a whole section of text bulleted, then you highlight those items, and anytime there is a line break, it will become a bulleted list. If you decide, I don't really want it to be bulleted, I'd rather it to be numbered, you can click like that. And there's actually several different types of options that you can have to change the look of your numbering system or your bullets. Sometimes you want arrows, those are kind of fun. Now, what's a genealogy report or project without citations? So let's talk about how to add footnotes to our reports. Footnotes are fairly easy. You could go to the end of the line, hit insert, footnote, or you can learn the shortcut key of Control Alt F or Command Alt F, and then it automatically adds a number and you can add your citation. And then I'm gonna do another citation. This time I'm using the quick reference. And notice I have number 1 and number 2. So there's number 2, and number 1 is in the middle of a paragraph right here. But let's say I want to add another citation in front of the 1. What's really great is Google Docs will keep track of your numbers and it will just push everything down for you. So now this becomes a 3, this is 2, and that's 1. And if you decide, oh, I'd rather want it down here, notice that it automatically ships your citation numbers. I love this feature. Now, let's say you don't like the default setting of the caption. So there really isn't a way to change the formatting of the captions. So let's go ahead and change the format. I typically don't like my citations more than 8-point font. Arial is okay. Let's say just for the fun of it, you wanted to have, don't ever use this for a citation, but maybe you wanted to be cursive. Why not? You get the idea that it's different. It's different from the default. So there's really no way to fix these citations other than doing it that manually, and that includes highlighting what you want, hitting the paint bucket or roller, highlighting what you want to change, and then it will change. But there's an easier way, and it involves something called an add-on. Click on Add-on, go to Get Add-ons, and then you're going to search for footnote style. Now I already have this installed, but walk through the process of installing this onto your computer. And what can happen is you can highlight the formatted citation that you want every other citation to look like. Click on add-ons, footnote style, match footnotes to style selection. That means I've highlighted the style I want all of them to look like. Click on that, and notice without any extra steps, all citations have changed to this format. If I want to change it to Verdana, which is, it's like Arial. It's just a different way look for Arial. Again, highlight, add on, match but not so style, and there we go. There we go. Quick and easy. If you have hundreds and hundreds of citation, this is a lifesaver. Oh my gosh. When I did a research report that had 300 citations and I wanted them all to be 8-point fonts, I had to go and format every single one, and it was a pain in the keister. So go ahead and use that match citations and it will shrink it. Now, be advised, if you are using any italicizing in your program, then those italicizing might shift and you might have to go back and do a italicizing again. But I really, really, really like this. It's pretty handy. Now, whenever you have a graphic, an image, or a photograph, you'll probably want to add them to your report. And the one negative thing about Google is they don't have an easy way to caption your images. But I'll show you a quick hack that's going to help you out. So what you're going to do is, instead of inserting image, we're going to insert a drawing. Click on Insert Drawing New. So now that this is open, I'm going to click Image. And I'm going to search for my image, and I'm going to select it, and it gets dropped right down in here. So then what I'm going to do is I'm going to do a text box below it and draw just something to start with. I like how it will pop up a little red guideline to say, hey, this is in line with the picture above. So then I can type in my caption, and I can click Save and Close, and it will truncate to... it's not going to have that extra drawing space. It's going to truncate to just what's there. And then I can do right click, wrap text, and now I have my captioned image. Another thing you're going to do is, maybe you made a misspelling. You can click edit and you can come right up back in here and change the, misspelled Geisler. Go figure. Just go ahead and change it. Click save and close. And you still always have the editing capability for that. You can also expand your image, decrease your image, and have the text wrap. I just want to point out that you want to make sure that your caption is a different font type and a different font size than the word around it. So I think this is a little bit too large. So I'm going to decrease this to 8, just because it's a larger font. The letters are larger in 8, 9, and 10 compared to Arial. So now you can see that there's definitely a difference between the two. Now, how many of you are considering just creating a bibliography for your project? Did you know that Google Docs has a citation and bibliography tool? I didn't until I started researching this video. So I definitely want to show you about it. Come to the end of your work, go to Tools, Citation, and then select the format. There's MLA, APA, and Chicago. So we're going to do Chicago, and we're going to choose from these options, Book, and I can do Print, Website, Online Database. So I can complete all the forms. There's lots of different choices here. I'm going to add an author, a title. Go through, and I think I'm done. So I can add a citation. So I can just corral all of my sources that I use. And then when I'm done, I can just do insert the references, and there all of my references are going to be compiled, my bibliography down there at the bottom. So those are just some of the really cool tools that you can use to enhance the look of your report using Google Docs for your genealogy project. If you have any other further suggestions, also use that comment section below. And I can't wait to talk to you about your future writing project. If you want more tips and tricks on how to write your family history stories, be sure to check out the playlist that's up above. And if you're ready for something new, check out that one. Text wrapping, I can recolor it. Let's say I want it red. Okay, I don't really want it red, but you can change some of the colors.